In this video, we're going to take a look at some of the signs that you'll be able to read to see whether your pasture is developing healthier soil or whether your pasture is actually declining.
So if I was doing a pasture assessment in the paddock, I'd look for nice fresh feed, not old and rank feed. I'd make sure our cattle are in excellent order. If they're slipping away, I know there's something wrong there. Soil structure and soil maintenance is basically what we're trying to achieve.
Healthy soil is going to be driven by healthy plants. It's going to be driven by biodiversity of plants in that community, and it's going to be driven by the state of the root mass of these different plants in the ground. So in this example here, we're standing in a paddock which hardly ever sees livestock. And so we're seeing a classic example of the death of a grazing ecosystem here. The kangaroo grass is dying from a lack of utilization. And if you're seeing a lot of this in your pasture, you know that your ecology is declining and you're losing biodiversity. People look at this and consider it to be a healthy covered soil. However, the soil is covered, but it's covered by detritus which can't break down because of a lack of humidity. This is now just sitting here, oxidizing and leaving the soil bare underneath. There are no seedlings, and if this happens to get burnt, which is very likely in the storm season, then all of this will be exposed and ready to wash away into the water systems around us.
When we first came here, there was a significant land tenant problem. And over the years, we've seen it progressively get worse, and also woody thickening. And what we were doing wasn't working, so we needed to instill some change, manage our country differently.
All these dying grass plants, what's actually happening is we're getting a shift from a grazing ecosystem where the biology digests the plant material that grows to one where it either oxidizes or gets decomposed by fungi that work at soil surface, resulting in a woodland. So we get a variation here from a grassland or grazing ecosystem working as a savanna with these trees through to a woodland. And this is the decline of the grazing ecosystem that you see here. What'll happen is a whole lot of plants will invade that area, which are woody, for example, the lantanic. So with the methods that we're gonna use to manage this country, we'll tighten that plant spacing and massively increase the productivity of this landscape. Here we are at a very good example of a healthy, biodiverse, mixed community of plants holding a soil together with living root systems and driving ecological health. Dung beetles have worked the dung. Worm castings left at soil surface, tightish plant spacings, and a well-covered soil that'll accept rainfall. Dung beetles are essential to the health of these ecosystems because the dung is the net outcome of the grazing effect, where the dung beetle then is going to complete that cycle and get this carbon and nutrient into the soil while it is also aerating the soil and making space for air and water to undo the compaction of where the animal actually walked and hardened that surface. And oh, look at that. There's a dirty great big hole dug by a dung beetle. The water is gonna go down that hole like a drain pipe. Beautiful. We've got two different soil colors, one above the other. The dung beetles being able to mix the two together. The yellow soil coming up through the profile here. Beautifully cool under here. Smells like fresh rain. There's actually still moisture in that soil. See how I can cut it up? That's because our plants are saving that moisture. They're using very little of it. And in the soil itself, roots foraging further down and busting that soil up and making this crumb structure, which is what we're looking for in a soil. Lots of space, lots of air in there, the ability to trade water and trade nutrient and drive a better quality feed above ground, which is what builds beef quicker and reduces the amount of feed an animal needs to get its nutritional requirement every day. In your landscape, you might find the same paddock. You've got over-trampled bare ground all around your waterways, around your drinking troughs. And that's what we're going to look at in the next video, is the how-tos of moving stock around to create a healthier ecosystem.